Welcome back to Let's Play The Legend of Heroes 3 from Zero. Last time left off, we started day 4 and continued to do some support requests while we were at it. We did the serial theft investigation and finally got started with the many famous use of crossbell, for which we still need one more picture, and that I will get this episode. But for the time being, let's continue with the main plot, which involves the Ash Tree Inn in Armorica Village. Oh goddess, if something ends up happening to my customers, my inn is done for. Please be safe. Excuse us? You're Mr. Geofront, right? We are the special support section. You submitted a support request to the CPD, didn't you? Oh, I'm saved. I've got a monumental problem on my hands, everyone. If I knew this was gonna happen, I would have tied them down while they were still in the village. Oh, this is all my fault. Sir, please try to calm down and explain the situation. What in the world happened? Sorry about that. I'm just a little overwhelmed by this fiasco. Allow me to start from the beginning. Yesterday, a foreign couple checked into my inn, everything was fine, but while I came to bring them breakfast in the morning, the room was empty, it was like they were never here. I have reason to believe that they ventured the ancient battlefield off of Old Armorica Road. That name rings a bell, a crossbell. I think I have mentioned it before, historians have found traces of an old battlefield off a branch of Old Armorica Road. If I remember correctly, wasn't the stone bridge connecting the paths down? Well, it was. It seems that it was repaired recently, though. No any random person can wander there all willingly. Why the frick did you repair an ancient bridge that was connecting to a battlefield that is filled with monsters? What's the CGF doing? That couple kept on talking about how they wanted to go sightseeing while they were still in Crossbell. Upon hearing that, I warned them about entering the battlefield, but that might have backfired, you think? The battlefield will probably make a sweet tourism spot. Randy, it's filled with freaking monsters! Is it really that dangerous though? Absolutely, that place is famous for housing a multitude of incredibly powerful monsters. Heck, even the villagers here know it would be crazy to try and go there. And on top of that, ever since the bridge was repaired, no one's been patrolling the area. That means we cannot confirm whether things have gotten better or worse. And those tourists have unsuspectingly wandered into a dangerous place. This is not the optimal situation, certainly. Agreed, we cannot take this lightly. Please, I'm begging you, can you find them and bring them back? For now, my friend Alfred is standing guard, making sure no one else enters the ancient battlefield, but at this rate, my customers will be in deep trouble. Understood, sir. You can leave everything to us. I assure you, we will find your tourists. It's not like we can refuse. You know, it would be a lot easier if tourists would listen when given advice, especially from locals. Nothing to do but track him down and bring him back. Thank you so much. You have no idea how much this means to me and the inn. If I lost them, I don't know. Geofront! One of his regulars, maybe? Keith, what's the matter? As you can see, I was in the middle of an important discussion. This is no time for discussions. You know how that couple went missing and now the inn is in the crapper because of it? Yes, I am fully aware. I just told these officers about the entire situation. Well, there is no need to freak out anymore. For the sake of the inn, I called in the cavalry.
The cavalry? What are you talking about?
Come on in here, don't be shy. My boss will explain the entire mess to you. Sure, lay it on me. Oh, hey Scott. I am Scott of the Bracer Guild.
So you have got a missing couple, is that right? If you don't mind, would you fill me on the details? I think we did hear that he was patrolling the highways last time. Hold on, a bracer? Why are you here? Huh? You're the special support section, aren't you? Given the circumstances, it would be wrong to call us meeting a coincidence. Keith, explain to me why you brought a bracer here, immediately. What do you mean? Whenever you are in a pickle, you gotta turn to the bracer guild, duh. When I heard about what happened, I sprinted all the way to Crossbell City to submit a request to the guild. I cannot fault you for caring, but I really wish you cleared it with me first. Just our luck. Oops. Dude, you have the worst timing ever. Huh? Why is everyone being so hostile right now? I don't really understand what is happening, but it is obvious that something is up. Sorry, but could I get a brief explanation on what is going on here? Sure, here's the rundown. So, that's how it is. This whole thing is a giant misunderstanding.
That may be, but what should we do about the missing couple? I am not sure what the proper protocol is for when the police and guild accept the same job.
Hey, we could always turn this into a fun competition. Who will be the first to find the tourists? Something like that, maybe?
Randy, that is not the issue here. Lloyd, what do you think we should do?
I have an idea. Scott, if you aren't opposed to it, why don't we work together? No complaints here. I was actually thinking the same thing.
Joining forces with the Bracer Guild?
Might as well, so we are searching for this ancient battlefield together, eh? No, we can split into groups. From what we have heard, this place is practically had enough monsters. And we need to secure the safety of those two tourists as soon as possible. I might be familiar with the general area, but the battlefield is no small place. If we split up, the probability of finding them will skyrocket. If we keep in contact with our Enigma, we should be able to find them relatively soon. True.
Indeed, that seems like the most reasonable strategy.
I am all for the plan. Lives are at stake here, the more help the merrier. SSS Scott, I am counting on you. And with the client's permission, we are good to go. Yeah, let's do our best. Alright, let's strike while the iron is hot. Oh, we exchanged contact info. I will head on to the ancient battlefield. Whenever you are ready, come catch up with me. I will see you later. Okay everyone, once you are prepared, let's make our way to the ancient battlefield too. After all, we don't want to fall too far behind Scott. And I think this is the first time that we canonically meet Scott in the game. Before this I don't even think he was involved in a side request or anything. But for the time being, let us head to the ancient battlefield, which should be on the first screen coming from Armorica. Yep, there it is. Just have to make my way over there. And this is the friend of the innkeeper, Alfred. Aren't you the special support section? A bracer just came here to look for the missing tourists. You may have heard the news and come to provide backup, right? Can you please assist him in locating them? Sure we can. A proxy puppet. There are some peculiar magazines inside the chest. You decide to leave them where they are, despite Randy's protests. Dude, come on, it's Nurses Monthly, we have to take it! No, Randy, just no. Oh, and these guys are the same that we have fought before. Back in my day, we had to work hard for our Curia bombs. And we definitely wouldn't have 99 of them in our second playthrough. No, sorry. Or in the first,
I remember having a shit ton of them in Cold Steel by the end of the game. How many do I have in Crosspell? 20. Well, let's move on to the ancient battlefield. Ooh, there's a river here. Maybe it's part of the Lupinus one. Wow, so this is what the ancient battlefield looks like. There are just as many ruins as I had heard. Great, it even has to rain in the game. And with a name like the ancient battlefield, I wouldn't be surprised if something nasty showed up. We all know I'm a betting man, so I am placing my chips on the ghosts of a long defeated army, or something equally crazy. Ghosts? Please no. Ellie? Ahem, you heard nothing. I have to say, the weather is harsh, and this place is infested with monsters. We don't have much time if the couple ventured further in.
Good call, Ellie. Let's get this search underway.
Well, we better hurry in that case. Although we do have some new enemies to take care of. Like these vampire thorns, which can suck our HP. It's weak to water. A plant that grows by sucking the nutrients from its prey. Impairs foes with its thorns. Needle seed, movement down, not that, ooh, wow, that movement down actually pressed up Lloyd pretty badly. In that case, let's go with an ice hammer. I am not too worried about my EP for the time being, seeing that I will get a level up relatively soon. And of course, as always, I have the girls equipped with elemental arts. Since this place doesn't have the higher elements active, not too worried about them. Let's go with a brave smash, why not? And he just had to get that 50% HP heal. Although getting that seal on this one is pretty handy. That wasn't too bad. Although there is a special enemy that can appear with those particular guys. They are a variant of the tomatoes. It's the same as with the bombs on the Main's mountain path, where you cannot encounter them normally on the field. Used by a mad warrior in the Middle Ages, can reflect physical damage and causes confusion. Great, that's just amazing. Yeah, these guys are not affected by physical attacks. Although if you use Team Rush, that won't be reflected. Although it also won't do any damage. So watch out for that. I should have Dark Matter, yeah. That should be the best way to deal with these guys. Other than that, let's go with an Ice Hammer and Heat Wave with Randy and Lloyd. Freaking confusion. Well, thankfully confusion doesn't affect arts, so he should be fine. Although I should heal him up. Interesting that confusion doesn't just cancel your casting, because a lot of things do. Like for example the combo crafts, if you use a combo craft with Lloyd and Theo is in the middle of casting an art, she would not cast it. Really, one just had to survive. You cannot get a stone spike in before Lloyd gets a turn. He shouldn't deal all that much damage. The worst thing he could do is petrify someone, I guess. Or just do nothing. And by the way, Theo's staff works on these guys. So that's handy. Oh yeah. Didn't see you there.
And these guys are the living totems. They can cast arts. Depicts the gods of the Middle Ages. The cart head chants a variety of arts. And this week too, nothing. Great. Well, it's still better to cast an art with the girls than to attack. What should I do to you? Well, Seal isn't really too good, seeing that he mostly specializes in arts. Let's go with a salamander to burn him. Let's at least let him get a turn in. Although, yeah, that Sepitap turn is just too irresistible. I almost have enough Sepit to get a million Mira for the record. Maybe I will get it after this mini dungeon. Well, actually I say mini, but it's pretty long for Trails games. A Tira Bomb. Inside you find a shirt that reads, "I checked this chest twice and all I got was this lousy t-shirt." You decide to not take it with you. Eh, I would have still taken it even if just to use it for a pajama. That's usually what I do with my shitty shirts. Ooh, a Sepit Demon. We fought these guys not too long ago, I think before the Kilika side quest. A Sepit Demon. I wonder if they give just as much Sepit as the boss variant. Sadly they do not. They only give 7 of each, unlike the 24 that was before. A strange monster with Sepit in masses in his body harnesses Carnelia Septium to breathe fire. That's the same description. But once again we have to scan them again. Sure, let's go with the Thunder Cyclone, just to mix it up. And these guys cannot be burned. I would say obviously, but that, well, this is basically the exception in most cases, seeing that some enemies use fire and can still be burned. That wasn't too bad. And Ellie does have the Ingenuity Quartz equipped, so her EP should be fine. Oh, also, do not use Ascrafts on the Cursed Shield. Just as a fair warning. Well, except Eos. Let's see, there is a path up here, but it leads to a dead end for the time being. I'm going to be exploring it later. There is a chest over there, nothing too amazing. New material. You brute. I cannot believe you took my chastity like that. You had better take responsibility. I am not even going to comment on that. Yeah, having to deal with those guys that can reflect is kind of a pain in the ass, especially when they come grouped up with other guys that can just be normally attacked with physical attacks. We chess people are actually in the middle of a war. I cannot give you more items because I am rationing. Good luck with your quest though. A chest war? Huh. But yeah, just watch out for when they are grouped together with other enemies. Especially when using Randy's S-Craft. I really want for Lloyd to get a level up finally, so that he can get one of the best crafts for him in the game. And Theo will also get a craft soon coming up here. Although that one is just okay at best. Oh no, this is just great. Well, that was a close call. Randy, while being confused, burned Theo. With the 10% chance from his weapon. And then Theo started casting arts and, well, yeah, her HP isn't doing great. And there, as you saw, the team rush only hit the 3 totems, and for the other ones it didn't really do much except for Theo.
But it didn't reflect the attack, so there's that. Oh, and it looks like counters don't count either, but they also don't deal damage. And there is a hidden chest behind here. Hit 3, ooh. That will be going straight onto Randy. I want to avoid any more Miseki, if you know what I mean. Yeah, there's of course still 2, the beginning part. I just don't want to relive that. How did you see me? Well, mostly by looking at the map. A curio bomb. I should really think about getting a roof installed. Still no luck with those tomatoes, sadly. I am so close to that freaking level up. Aha, level up! And we get Burning Heart and Energy Cycle for Theo. And what Burning Heart does is that it gives you a Strength, Defense and Speed buff, a plus 50% boost, and it knows all ailments. It's almost like a Spirit Unification, except it doesn't change your crafts. And Energy Cycle is a basic healing one that can cure all ailments and stat down. Yeah, it's pretty nice. We don't really need Breath or Holy Breath on Theo anymore, if you don't want that. Why did you run away? Not the best fight to show off Burning Heart. Oh, Lloyd has Intimidation on, that is why they ran away. That makes sense. Oh, a monster chest. With some totems. Well, this kinda sucks. Although I am separated, so arts shouldn't be able to affect too many party members. Can I get these totems without hitting the masks? I cannot. Well, in that case, just delay the 2 tower casting. And Lloyd, you go ahead and show off Burning Heart. If the buffs wear off, this does inflict him with Faint, but you can just reapply it over and over again. And since I have the Gladiator headband on him, he will gain CP just normally, and he shouldn't really run out of the buff ever really. But the Strength, Defense and Speed boost just combined with the Ailment Resist just makes him the perfect tank of the games. Although Trails from Azure does nerf it a lot, but we'll get to that. Let's go with a Quake. And of course let's gather them in one place. Dark Matter is just too good to pass up on. Yeah, the totems resist all of the arts, so not really much I can do about that. And there is Gorgon Breath, which can petrify you. Thank you for not petrifying Ellie as well. That would have sucked. Well, Theo is in a pickle. Let's see, what heals petrify? A softening ointment. Although now Lloyd went closer to Theo and she is also in range of the art. Oh, you can get off an art before they cast it themselves. That should work. I do need some healing, let's go with a Holy Breath. Randy should have enough HP to survive a reflect or 2. Oh, it was only 1. Alright, nothing too bad. be careful with casting arts with Lloyd when he has the burning heart on, seeing that it does decrease it by 2. They should be able to finish them. There we go. Even got some overkills. And Ellie and Randy finally catched up. Ooh, a heal quartz, although it's not all that amazing. Meh, the NEC PC-8801 version of this chest had a way better soundtrack. It was before your time. You wouldn't get it. Yeah, some of the older Falcon games were on that system. Is that who I think it is? Scott? Oh, hey, it's you guys. You're quick on your feet, eh? Yeah, well, we are kinda used to running all over the state at this point. But hey, is that lady one of our tourists? After I made sure she was alive and breathing, I noticed that she had a Calverdian passport. So yeah, I think she's one of our targets. How is she holding up? She's fine. Shocked of seeing all of these nasty monsters knocked her out cold. Don't worry. I took care of them. See? Not a scratch on her. Wow, guess Scott is getting some extra BP.
Phew, thank goodness you were here, Scott. The support request mentioned a couple, so where is the second half? Could he have ventured deeper inside?
If that is the case, we need to locate him as soon as possible. He seriously left his lady behind and ran. Cannot say he is the shining example of a gentleman.
Well, I cannot particularly blame him if he was cornered by monsters.
You guys go on ahead without me, I'll watch over her a little longer. If you could go and search the interior, I'd owe you one. That shouldn't be a problem, thank you, Scott. I'm going to continue treating this woman for a little bit longer. Go ahead without me, I will catch up with you guys later. Well, we still have some monsters to take care of over here. Let's make sure to clear out the area. Wow, Reflect can actually inflict the ailment that you were about to inflict. For example, one of Randy's attacks got reflected and he got inflicted by burn because of the heat device. Huh, that's interesting. And another proxy puppet. I think that's the second one in this episode alone. We are working on a mod that replaces Randy with a pepperoni pizza. Please look forward to it. Ah, I thought it would be a dolphin. Well, anyway, another reason Burning Heart is so good is that it gives you a strength buff. And as I stated before, when using combo crafts, only Lloyd's strength buff gets calculated into the damage output. Oh, and also you get a turn as soon as you use it, as you can see on the turn order. Did you know that Tria, the receptionist at the Crossbell News Service, has a red pyramid on her desk? Well, now you do. Not sure what I'm going to do with that information, but thank you. What is this place? It's enormous.
I believe this is a ruin referred to as the Sun Fort. Its origin and history are shrouded in mystery, but historians estimate it was constructed at least 500 years ago.
Yep, it sure looks like a fort to me. Heck, I'd even call it a fortress. Figure it must have been used as one during the Middle Ages. Is everything alright, Theo?
Yes, I'm fine. It's just, I thought I felt something odd resonating from within the ruins.
What do you mean by odd? Well, it still looks like a plain old rundown fort to me, but who knows what kind of creepy stuff scrolling inside there.
I am sorry I worried you, I am sure it was only my imagination. More importantly, we should return our attention to the tourist. Our search will be much more difficult if he entered these ruins. We do not have time to spare.
Right, let's keep going.
We might be able to take one of Grace's photos here later. We've got other things to do, to worry about right now. We need to hurry up and find the tourists before anything happens to them.
Really, Lloyd? We cannot take 5 seconds to take a picture.
No, we have to come back here later to retrace our steps to get a freaking picture. Even though right now, at this point, I can return to Crossbell City and stock up. Yeah, that makes a whole lot of sense. Screw you, Lloyd.
Anyway, we are now in an underground waterway, I guess. There are some new enemies here. Nothing too amazing. These are the vampire bats. Once again, they can suck your HP. Speaking of HP, Theo doesn't have a whole lot. Let's just use a battle scope in that case. A vampire bat known as the Blood Goman saves physical strength, TP and CP from foes. Great, just what I like to hear. I guess these guys are kinda like POMs. Let's go with the Brave Smash to hit multiple, and also to seal them, so that they cannot suck my CP. Crash Bomb to blind them. That should be enough to disable them. Although that one still hit Lloyd. Theo is basically out of EP, but I think I will use something else than EP charges to restore it. Oh yeah, I completely forgot, we got the heal quartz not too long ago from that monster chest. It slowly recovers your HP by walking around. It's not that great. I really wish it would give a bit more water elemental value than 3. That's not too amazing, seeing that most of the quartz that I have already give that. Anyway, I want to take off the ingenuity from Ellie and give it to Theo for the time being. Just to recover some EP. And then walk around like a madman in circles. A celestial bomb. Listen, I'm not that kind of chest. I was drunk and young and I thought it would be okay if it was you. Alright, this amount should do for the time being, so let's get the ingenuity back on Ellie. And you can have your Libra gem back. What is this supposed to be? And this. The Grave Flyer and the Merman. Yeah, it kinda looks like a Merman from Castlevania. I should probably move Lloyd a bit closer to Randy so that Anchorage can hit him. A flying monster that swarms the battlefield. Everything is destroyed in their wake. Not too much information to go off of. And another enemy that can speed you down. Didn't see the Sepit upturn. I was a bit late on the trigger there. Although now that stupid fly got out of the way of dark matter. Ouch. Yeah, this little underground passageway got some unique enemies for some reason. They only show up here. The horizon rod. Use it well, comrade in rods. That I will, I can finally finish the fishing side activity of the game.
Please take our chest. Satisfaction survey.
Honestly, I wasn't really blown away by that item, so I will give you a 3 out of 10.
Ooh, a steel bomb, that's more like a 10 out of 10.
You need the More Chest Messages DLC to view this message.
No thank you. The freaking costumes that games give these days are bankrupting me already, as it is.
Ooh, another new enemy. I think it's the last one. The Zoo.
Is that a Final Fantasy IV reference?
A wild bird of prey that scavenges for corpse meat is weak to earth. I really should be watching my HP better. Although casting with Lloyd doesn't really make much of a difference since I'm going to be using his S-craft. And that sealed him, so he shouldn't really be able to do anything. These are just a variation of the fall eagles that we have fought before. And Randy, go ahead and heal everyone. This is the last area we have to explore for the time being, for the ancient battlefield. That is the way to the old Armorica Road that was the screen we were on previously, before finding the tourist and Scott. I really hope I can reach a level up, if only just to restore my EP for Lloyd. Nothing down there. Ooh, an HP tree. They say that to err is human, indeed. By your hands, I am now naught but air. And it is raining again. Yeah, for some reason there are some rain effects here. Actually, was there a fishing point over at the underground waterway that I forgot about? I believe there was. Oh well, it doesn't really matter. I will be fishing later on. I do have to come back to take the picture anyway. So it doesn't really matter. Inside the chest you find a smaller chest. Inside that chest is an even smaller chest. Inside that chest is another even smaller chest. Inside that chest is a Schrödinger's cat. And by flipping this lever, we can open a gate. Which will lead us back to the beginning. It's a bit of a shortcut. And here is the chest. An EP charge. If a cluttered chest is a sign of a cluttered mind, then what's an empty chest a sign of? A no-good thief. Sometimes it's weird that enemies that are flying are weak to earth elemental attacks, because how the hell is Quake hitting them? I think some games do that where aerial enemies are immune to earth elemental attacks. And here is another pretty well hidden chest inside this building. A battle jacket. You open the chest and peer downward, only to find a clay hand making a certain gesture. Got him. Gosh darn it! And before heading down that way, we should probably save. And I also want to give Theo Genesis Flood. As always, it's just good to have an all-hitting art, so I don't have to worry about positioning. Everything else should be fine. Oh, I forgot to give you your gladiator headband, why not? I should probably restore EP, sadly I did not get that level up, and I don't really feel like running around
with the ingenuity quartz. I can always just buy more of them. Yeah, that should do.
Someone, please help me! There he is, Lloyd.
Yeah.
Why is this happening to me? Help! Can anybody help me? Goddess, please have mercy. Hold it!
Talk about impeccable timing, eh? Save the dude from going splat by mere seconds.
Please explain how this timing is in any form impeccable.
We are with the Crossbell Police Department. You all are under arrest. I mean, we'll distract the monsters for you, so make a run for it.
Okay.
Whoa! What's with these monsters? They look seriously tough.
They seem to be different from the usual monsters inhabiting the area. Are they from ancient times?
Well, either way, we'd better not go easy on them. Think it's about time we show our friends a lesson in pain.
Here they come.
And these guys can hit pretty hard. You want to watch out for that. These are the blade fangs. Let's go with an analyze first of all. An ancient reptile monster. It increases its strength by roaring. Yeah, they have a self-buff move. They resist petrify and instant death. But everything else is good to go. Let's see, Ellie, you might as well start casting something. A thunder cyclone wouldn't hurt. Although, well, they are weaker to water, that's why I gave Theo the art, but I guess we could go with a dark matter to decrease their movement. But Lloyd and Randy are in a bit of a pickle, seeing that these guys can hit pretty hard. Let's go with a burning heart, first of all. Buff everything. And after that, a brave smash to disable some of them, hopefully. Well, I got both of them. That's ideal. And for the first turn, for some reason, they don't do anything. But I can blind them, that should help a lot. Ooh, and I even got a burn on one of them, thanks to the weapon that Randy has. And by the way, this fight is completely optional to win. You don't have to. Not sure why. Like, it's not even that hard, but you get extra 3 DP for it. The Tiger Charge. I think these guys give a lot of Sepit. Yeah, that's pretty nice, although they don't give any of the higher elemental ones. Theo, Genesis Flood. Ellie should probably heal up Lloyd, just to be safe. Because even with blind, they can sometimes hit me. Power Smash. And here is Genesis Flood. Would have liked to use an ultimate mix on Theo beforehand, but oh well. And there is the Libra Gem in effect. It restored some of Theo's EP. Sadly, it's not enough for another Genesis Flood. So I will probably have to use an EP charge, and he just had to get an 50% HP heal. Gosh darn game. Another EP charge, and another Genesis Flood. Although now I do want to use an ultimate mix, just to make this go by a bit faster. Yeah, this fight is kind of a cake if you use status ailments, like blind and seal, especially seal. And Lloyd is about to run out of his buff, but I can always just reapply it. Ooh, a rush. Sadly, she doesn't have enough EP for another Genesis Flood. Should I show off what happens if you run out of buffs? You know what, sure, why not? If you reach zero buff status, you go into faint. For a turn, at least. So make sure that you don't do that. And another Tiger Charge on this one. It has the most HP, plus its seal is about to go away. And this fight is over. A few water arts. Oh, I can finish it with a team rush, why not? Not even gonna use turbo mode. Ooh, a triple overkill. And a level up all around. And then he gets a strike bell. Oh boy! That's a really good craft as well. And some new materials. Did we defeat them?
Phew, that was tougher than I had anticipated.
Well, that was a freaking pain. The hell are these things? You cannot be serious.
Oh no.
Can't you stay down for 1 second? I am way too beat to think about fighting again. This is bad. Really bad. We need to find a way out of this situation. Huh? Strike! Was that what I think it was? Second form, Gale. Arios. I made it just in the nick of time. No, hold on just a damn second. What are you even doing here? An awfully cold reception, considering I just saved your lives. Scott took it up himself to handle the request on his own. I am aware of how dangerous the area can be, so I thought I would offer my assistance.
Thank you for saving us, Arios. We appreciate it. We were incredibly lucky.
You can fool the ladies, but damn near perfect timing ain't fooling me. You had the whole thing planned from the start, didn't ya? Oh no, pal. You ain't striking your way into this heart. I will leave it to your imagination. Hey, are you guys alright? Oh, Scott. It looks like she finally woke up. Yep, not too long ago.
Thank you so much, everyone. I don't know how I will ever be able to repay you, Bracers.
Seriously, we even got to see an awesome show. You took down those insane monsters with one fell swoop.
Scott, I think I felt my heart flutter when you saved me. And your skill with a trifle was just...
Oh god. Wait, honey! I am just glad the two of you are safe. History is doomed to repeat itself.
Don't fret too hard, Randy. At least we all work together to save the tourists, right? I would consider this mission accomplished.
Something up, Arios? Not particularly. I think we should focus on escorting these two back to Armorica Village. Watch our 6 special support section. Understood. Everyone, thank you for bringing them back safely. I was almost done for. Don't mention it, Mr. Gofan. I am not sure what would have happened if not for Scott and Arios being there, though. Hopefully those tourists take a long, nice nap before doing anything else. On a side note, those bracers are some serious guys. They sure like to stay on top of things, don't they?
I cannot deny that bracers all seem to have impeccable timing. At least we were able to finish the support request without too many issues. Yes, but one problem remains. During the support request, the guild and the police worked side by side. Now that it's over, how should we go about reporting this?
Good point. What's your call, Lloyd? This definitely wasn't a standard case for us, that is for sure. I said it before, but if Scott and Arios hadn't been there, I'm not sure if we would have been as successful as we were. I think this time we should give them the credit for resolving the request. That won't be necessary.
Arios, Scott.
Gofon, it seems as if those two wish to apologize. They have reflected on their ways and regret ignoring your warning about the ancient battlefield.
Oh, is that so?
It is not as if I'm going to lose sleep over this ordeal, but... Hopefully, this was a good lesson for them.
Excuse me, Scott. What did you mean by that won't be necessary?
Well, I have talked it over with Arios, and we came to a decision. We want the SSS to be the ones to say they completed the request. Did I hear you right? Looking back on the case, you two clearly did the heavier lifting. That's not true. Since you all were able to go on ahead, that bought me time to look after the lady. And if you hadn't made it to that man in time, I am not sure if he would have made it. Sure, our results may sound nice on paper, but in the grand scheme of things, we think the SSS was crucial to the request's success. Feels sort of embarrassing to be praised by your rivals, eh? I wouldn't say we are rivals in the slightest. The special support section. It appears as if you have matured a little since we first crossed paths. Especially you, Lloyd. What? Do you remember when we first met in the Geofront? Back then, you decided to recklessly throw away your life, fighting against an unbeatable foe, as if you were some kind of martyr. But this time, you refrained from doing that. Despite your odds being slim, you kept searching for a way to break through the situation. One requires unwavering strength to relentlessly go against all odds. Be sure to seize your destiny, such strength is far more powerful than sacrificing your own life. Though your ability cannot be denied, the fact that you were able to find another way against all odds is proof in itself that you have become stronger. Thank you. It seems I have talked too much. Scott, return to Crosspass City and report to the guild. Roger, Arios. Well, special support section, it was a pleasure. I hope we can get the chance to work together again someday. Likewise.
I would be lying if I said I was expecting to hear encouragement from Arios McLean. Theo, don't be rude, but you are right. It was a little peculiar.
I wouldn't let it bother you. We finished the support request, didn't we? That is enough to be happy about. Yeah, I agree with the redhead. Special support section, thank you once again. I will be knocking if I need help again. You can always rely on us, sir. We'll be waiting at the door. And that is the missing tourist done with. That was a pretty lengthy side request, although it was pretty nice getting to see Arios again, and Scott got some screen time. But back to Crosspass City. Since we finished the urgent request,
I am guessing we are about to get a phone call. Well, actually, ain't it already past noon? Damn, looks like we didn't make it back in time for the parade.
A shame. I have heard rumors of Mishi riding in a car.
Yeah, searching the ancient battlefield ended up being a lot tougher than I anticipated. Let's head back to the SSS and take a much-needed break.
Yes, let's.
Oh, no phone call. Oh god. Oh no. Please don't tell me that. Oh no. NPC dialogue got updated. I think I will leave that for next time. But for now, let's head back to the SSS. Well, it seems like Colin is missing, but well, I think that can wait. I'm sure he's fine. We have some fishing to do, which is a lot more important. I'm sure Mr. Hayworth will understand. And there is the support request that we finished. And we still need to finish the many famous use of Prospell. So let's head back to the ancient battlefield.
Oh, it's the Sunfort again. We were in the middle of an emergency the last time we were here, so I didn't have much of a chance to take it all in.
Yeah, likewise. But that reminds me, Theo, didn't something about it bother you? Oh yeah, guess you did mention getting some weird vibes from inside the fort.
How do you feel, Theo? I am fine now. I may have simply gotten used to the feeling though. That aside, couldn't we take some photos of the fort for Grace's guide?
Oh yeah, that's a pretty good idea. Will you do the honors, Ellie?
Okay, leave it to me. Phew, I hope they turned out okay.
Nice, Ellie. You look pretty confident taking that picture. Shall we move on? And that's the last picture that we needed. Yeah, we had to do the support request first. But before heading back, I still need to get some treasures, and there is also a fishing point down here somewhere. Oh, never mind, it was actually on the previous screen, on the ancient battlefield screen one. It's right over here. Kinda hard to see from the menu down there. I bet the fish here are really battle tested. We want to use the... where is it? Snow crab to fish in this spot, but I only have one, so let me quickly save. Could have gotten this earlier, but oh well. Might as well get them all at the same time. Here we get an arch crab, and that is not the thing I wanted. I will just reload over and over until I get the reward I want from it. There we go, I got the mind tree as a reward for catching it. I do want to get some of those, since they are the easiest way of obtaining those. Also, I forgot to equip the HP tree on Theo, but I will be messing around with that later. I do want to get at least one more mind tree from that crab, but I don't have any more snow crabs on me, sadly. But before leaving the ancient battlefield, let's return to the area where we fought those giant dinosaurs, I guess, because there are some chests that I can get over there, which were inaccessible due to the cutscene. Here we are. Oh yeah, I still haven't gotten those tomatoes. Can I just fight this thing over and over? There we go! The sweet Tometrian. Let's just use a quick battle scope on them. A plant monster that is entirely sweet. Touching it makes you lose your mind. I just wanted to get the scan on them. And they can confuse you. That's just great. Another enemy that can confuse us. Oh, you petrified Randy. Good job, Lloyd. That's what we wanted. Oh yeah, I have energy circle which can heal ailments. Let's use that. How convenient. There we go. I want to conserve Lloyd's CP for an upcoming monster chest. You check the chest to see it full of fan mail addressed to the SSS. It's sweet, but you wonder how it got there. And here is the last chest that we can get. It's right to the northwest of the Sun Fort. It's a monster chest. I think it's the same enemies. Yep. And here is Strike Bell. It's a craft that we have gotten earlier after the fight with the dinosaurs. It has Accelerate, manifests the time barrier and destroys it, advancing turns. It's the same thing that Sherahead and Machia sing Cold Steel. It can give you a turn right after you use it, but it doesn't work on the character that is using it, only for your party members. But it can be really powerful if used correctly. Hey, Ascent Quartz! You may have met my brethren. Between you and me, they are a little unhinged. Nice. Anyway, the Ascent Quartz. It attracts enemies, but it does give you a lot of the elemental values for all of the other elements other than wind, so it's really nice for a caster. And usually I just kill every enemy anyway, so it doesn't really matter. I think it overrides intimidation, the quartz that intimidates enemies. Not that it really matters. Anyway, there is one more fish that I forgot that we can fish at this spot, so I might as well get it. And I also need to buy some dumplings for the other fish, the dumpling DXs from the Fisherman's Guild. But I still need to use a carp to fish another fish. Oh, I have 8. Yeah, that should be enough. Another save. There it is, the queen crab. It can give you a megaduta if you really want to, but I don't really care. So let's just move on. Megadutas are the ones that can block, seal and mute.
It's the accessory. Let's see, I should need at least... let's get 10, they are pretty cheap. Let's see, let's head to the second screen of the East Crossbell Highway. And here I am on the East Crossbell Highway, the second screen coming from Crossbell City. And I want to use a carp once again. With the horizon rod that we got. There it is, the demon catfish. And it can give you an action tree, which I really want to get. There it is, an action tree. I will probably get more off screen, I don't really want to waste my time while recording. But let's head over to the rest stop over at Armorica Road. And here it is. If I could ever find the icon that lets me fish, that is. Ah. What kind of rest area would be complete without a fishing spot? And I want to use the dumpling DXs, the deluxe dumplings. Oh, I could have used the bamboo rod for them. Oh well, it doesn't really matter all that much. I don't need an Armorican carp, thank you game. There it is, the noble carp. This is what I wanted. And we get the Pisces gem. What the heck did I just catch? I have never seen a fish so beautiful before. I feel like it might be kind of rare. Let's see what that gem does that we just got. May evade magic attacks. Yup. And it gives you 5 time elemental value. Pretty nice. But I still need to open some slots to actually make use of these. For now, let us head over to the Geofront B sector. There was that one fishing spot over there. And here it is, it's right over at the boss area where we fought the giant vacuum cleaners and the blob. Once again, I have to use the carps to fish over here. I don't want another queen crab. There it is, the electric eel. And it can give you an EP cut 3, which I really want. Alright, I'm having a pretty hard time getting the EP cut 3s, so I'm just going to come back here later. But just believe me, they do give it to you. I might as well talk to Yona while we are here. That kitty is a real jerk. She didn't come online once today, I mean, what's up with that? No way. Did she actually end up going to see that dumb parade? What am I saying? Kitty is probably just as big a shut-in as me. There is no way she'd go to an IRL festival. I don't think I have the whole story, but I guess Kitty is someone like Yona. At the very least, Yona thinks she is. Despite how he acts, Yona tends to get lonely easily. And the last fish that we need is over in Main's mining village. Well, more specifically the mine itself. Ah, here is the fishing point. Right at the end of the abandoned mine. Yeah, you have to come all the way down here manually. There aren't even any enemies left. Once again, we need the deluxe dumplings. And we get the gold salmon, a Taurus gem. What the heck is this? Well, it's gorgeous, that's for sure. Is this some kind of rare fish? And Those two fish that Lloyd commented on, the noble carp and the gold salmon, are one of a kind. You cannot catch another one of them, sadly. But we are still missing one more fish. But I think we have fulfilled the requirements for a rank up over at the Fisherman's Guild, so let's do that. Oh, the Tauros gem, right. Absorbs 25% of physical damage dealt as HP. Wow. That's nice. Yeah, all of these quartzes are not only really powerful, but also level 2 quartzes. Sardan examined Lloyd's fishing notebook. Holy crap, you've managed to fish up the ever elusive noble carp and even the golden salmon? This is unreal, Lloyd. Starting today, you are now a master fisher. And we get the Aqua Wizard. Yeah, did it, kid. You managed to ascend to my level. We can finally discuss the golden salmon's glorious tail fin. And the feeling of the noble carp's powerful tug on your line. Dude, I'm really not into that. As a fellow master fisher, I can definitely say that you are a fishing sage now. Pretty stoked to have another friend reach this level. Afraid I've got nothing left to teach you, Lloyd. It is up to you to figure it out from here, kid. Wow, this feels like a dream. Thank you for everything, Sardan. There is just one more thing. There hides a mythical guardian of Crossbell's waters. A fish so immense, no one's caught it before. It is rumored that the Aqua Wizard I just gave you has the strength to reel that bad boy in. If you ever feel like you are up to the task, then challenge yourself to finally capture this legend of the deep. And I will do just that. Right now, let's head over to the Ursula Byroad. And here we are, right by the ruins. Which kinda reminds me I do have to turn in the pictures for Grace also. And over here we have to use the Aqua Wizard in combination with the Viper Head. But before that, let me save. Don't really want to lose the only Viper Head I have. And we get the Serpent Head, and the Grail Locket, and the Record. Whoa! What even is this thing? It's huge! Is this seriously a fish? I thought my rod was going to snap in half. Today's gotta be my lucky day. Oh man, I bet Sardan's going to flip when he gets a load of this. And we get the Grail Locket, which, well, as in every Trails game, prevents all status ailments, but well, since Lloyd has the Burning Heart, he doesn't really need it. But that completed our fishing notebook, so let's return to the Fisherman's Guild one more time. Glorious! You actually managed to catch the guardian of the lake itself, the Serpent Head. I cannot believe my eyes. You've gone and done it, Lloyd. I think I might even start crying. Yeah, I figured it was that insane fish you told me about. I was totally shocked by how large this thing was. That legendary fish has been the Crossbell Branch arch nemesis for years. But now that you have caught it, it can only mean one thing. It is time I bestowed upon you a special title. And that title is known as the Divine Angler. This renowned title has only ever been awarded to one person in one branch. The Divine Angler Emblem. Never would I have expected you to surpass me and become a Divine Angler. I hope you never stop doing what you're doing, Crossbell's very own Divine Angler. This is incredibly embarrassing. But you have supported me in more ways than I can count. I will keep relying on you for all the matters in fishing. Sounds good, Sardan? I see you are still humble, kid, despite all you have accomplished. Don't have it any other way. Alright then. Let's see what that accessory does. The Divine Angler Emblem. Accuracy plus 50%. It's alright. Nothing too insane. And everyone else other than Lloyd can equip it as well. But there is still one more reward we can get for fishing. And that is by selling them. No, I'm just kidding, don't really do that. But we can get some nice amount of sepit out of it. Let's head back to the special support section and feed Kope. Let's see what kind of rewards we can get for the... Where the hell is Kope? Oh, he's in the kitchen. Huh, wait a second. Kope, didn't I just give you your food? Oh no, I can't feed him today. Gosh darn it, game. I guess it will have to wait for tomorrow. Oh well. How did you get food? Oh well, let's not think about it. Guess that all will have to wait for tomorrow. Or the next day, I mean. Let's see, can I get a million Mira now? I can, yes! Trade Sepit, and I get another record. Miracle Miranier, and we also got the Anglo-Saxon Invasion. Those are both worth 100 points, and you should probably save on a different slot to make sure the records actually stay with you. But I don't need the Mira, so let's reload. And I think it's about time I stopped hoarding the freaking Sepit. So I think it's time we upgraded some slots. Oh, I was actually able to upgrade every slot. Huh, didn't think that was going to happen, but there you go. I now reached maximum EP with everyone. Yeah, Theo has 771 EP. Well, I could always give her some EP2s and EP3s to boost that even further. Not that I really need to. But I guess I don't really need a Sepit anymore, seeing that, well, I can just fish for the action trees and EP cut trees, which are the most important ones. And I always need the money, of course. But for now, let's head over to the Harbor District and report the pictures to Grace. Oh, and she does have a pyramid on her desk. Oh wow, it looks like you managed to take a lot of photos. I will call Grace and let her know. Are you ready to submit them? Okay, this should be all of them. Yep, looks like you managed to take enough of them. Also, could you return the orbital camera you borrowed? We will start developing the photos right away. Ah, I nearly forgot about that. I am excited to see how they turned out. Yep, well, we'll get right to it. Anyway, Grace should be waiting on the second floor. Welcome back, guys. A job well done. The photos you brought are finally developed and raring to go. Let's take a peek, shall we? Ah, the rustic landscape of the old Armorica Road. Just one glance fills me with tranquility. Oh, this one is Armorica's flower garden. Their delicious honey is to die for. Oh wow, are these the mysterious ruins hanging over by the mouth of the Lupinus River? Remove the monsters from the equation, and this would be the ideal dating spot. What the heck? Where did you even take this? I gotta say, the emptiness brings you about a soothing tranquility. And there is the money shot. It wouldn't be a sightseeing tour guide without Main's Mountain Pass waterfall. It truly is a sight to behold, isn't it? I cannot help but stare at it longingly.
when I take the bus out to Mainz. Oh, you even managed to snap a shot of the railway. Is this the one near the West Crossbell Highway? I have seen my fair share of train fanatics out in the city, so I am glad we managed to get one photo of it. Is this Stargazer's Tower? It is not exactly the safest place to tread through, but it's still a nice and quiet spot, away from the hustle of the city. Whoa, ruins! You're telling me there's a place like this on the Mainz mountain path? It looks like some kind of ancient temple. I can just feel the mystery oozing from it. You're kidding me. None of our records indicate a ruin like this on the ancient battlefield. It definitely gives me that Middle Age fortress vibe. If we convince bracers to guard the place, it could be an outstanding tourist attraction. Unbelievable! Each and every one of them are flawless. Masterfully done, Ellie. If I'm being totally honest, this is kind of work that puts professionals to shame. Consider me impressed. It would be better to start looking into a way to convince Ellie to replace Reigns as our main photographer. I think you are laying on the compliments a little thick. I am relieved you enjoyed them though. You heard that, Elle? Masterfully done, she says. Not only were the photos fantastic, but you even managed to give me a double helping. You guys are the best. I think it's safe to say that we are totally set. All that is left to do is add a nifty little introduction, and then it will be completely finished. Alright. I'm glad to hear that, Grace. I see it was wise to trust in the eye of a detective. You were able to track down all these glorious spots like it was nothing. Heaven forbid I admit this, but a tour guide written by you might even surpass my own. I hope you aren't implying another request. No. Anyway, the SSS really saved my skin. I will keep you guys on speed dial for whenever I need you, okay? Yes, well, instead of that, just submit another support request, okay? Yeah. Thanks, everyone. Well then, duty calls, so I will leave you be. Bye-bye! Man, leave it to Grace to submit a request that makes us work up a sweat. True, but I hadn't held the camera in so long that I sort of got a kick out of it. I actually don't mind doing requests like this every once in a while. You were definitely acting like a kid in a toy store. On the other hand, keeping up with Grace can become exhausting after a while. Yeah, you could say that again. And that should be the last request for the time being. Yep, everything is done and accounted for. So let's head back to the special support section and report it. Still no rank up? Really, game? Oh well. Wait, what was the main plot about again? Oh yeah, Colin went missing or something like that. I think that we'll have to wait for next time. Well, let's play The Legend of Heroes, Trails from Zero. Thank you guys for tuning in. Until then, have a good one.